Hello, this video is going to help you prepare for online learning at Ayrshire College this year. I'm going to show you one way in which you can join lessons with your lecturer online. If you haven't watched the other video from Ayrshire College about signing into Office 365, please do that. That's a really important step for you. And the website that we used in that video was called office.com, and it looked like this. So don't worry if the picture changes the next time you go in, but if you haven't been there already, please watch that video and sign into Office 365 through that website. There's actually a better way to sign into Office 365 while you're at college. And what I'd like you to do is go to the college website. It's at www.ayrshire.ac.uk, and I'd like you to go up here on the top line and click on My Learning. When you do that, you'll be taken to this page, and you'll notice right in the middle of the page, I've put a red box around it. There's a button that says Log In using Office 365. Now, we've already logged into Office 365. So there's what appears to be happening now is there's a connection between this page and the Office 365 website from Microsoft. They're connected. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on this button, and you'll be taken to this page. Your screen will look like this. Now I've blanked out another email address that I use so that it doesn't distract you, and you can see that I'm about to click on this student email address that I used in the first video. Now the screen then has some activity, and we're eventually taken to this screen. And now I'm going to put in my password for the student account. By the way, I've changed that password, and that's what I would advise that you do following the instructions that I gave in the last video through the ICT help guide. Anyway, I'm going to sign in. I'm going to click sign in, put my password in, and now I'm taken to the My Learning page. And My Learning is actually the central place where you will find all of the tasks that lecturers set. We use My Learning, and by the way, My Learning is a new name for Moodle. So if you've been at college before, this is Moodle. It just has a different appearance. So what we're seeing now is My Learning, the central place where staff will put tasks for you and your class. And I've highlighted in red with the border that it recognises me as Annie Leith, the example student I'm using in this. But look at this part on the right-hand side. It also has brought in Office 365. And that's really important because now you're getting two things in the one place. We're in Microsoft Learning, previously called Moodle, and we're also actually able to access Office 365. Okay, let's just take a moment to highlight something that you should follow up on and sign. It's a student agreement about being online. So if I click on it, we see this. And then we see the student agreement. And if you scroll to the bottom of the page, you can put your name in and agree to the terms of using the college's facilities for learning. So please take a moment to fill that in. You get a wee thank you once you've done it. Okay, let's come back to that page in My Learning. So what I would like you to do is click on My Email. You'll see this, some activity on your screen. And then you'll be shown the Office 365 email page. And here's a kind of welcome. So it recognises that this is the first time I've been in through this route. And I've just clicked that to say that's fine, clicked a wee X. And what I can see now is, oh, it looks like I'm in an email system. And I've highlighted in red that I've got a message from Charlotte Mitchell through the Student Association. And when I click on that message, Charlotte is saying to us that the college wants to ensure that that the college is actually aware of every learner and their needs, any barriers that might exist for that learner. So there's a questionnaire that the college are offering, and we'd like you to follow the link and complete that. So roughly about well over 6,000 students have completed it already, and it's been really helpful in helping the college identify where we can put in more support, how confident students are feeling, areas where we maybe need to work on students' IT skills to prepare them for blended learning. And this video is part of our response to the information that we've got from the student survey. So please, please, please follow this link and share your views about coming to college this year. We want it to be a good experience, and you've got an opportunity here to share your views with us. Okay, so one of the things that is perhaps worrying you as a learner is this phrase blended learning, because blended learning means classes in person, but also classes being delivered online with the lecturers in their house or in the college and you're in your house. So a question that a lot of students will have is, how will I know what to do and where to go in the first week for classes that are actually delivered online? Because I'm not going out my house. What do I actually do? And the answer actually lies in your email and messages that your lecturer will send you. So let me show you how that actually works. So we just signed into My Learning and we saw this screen. We saw the centre where it says Annie Leith and below it. And eventually, Annie will have lots of courses attached to her or classes attached to her. But at the right-hand side, she can access her email. So if I go into the email, here's what could happen to you. I've highlighted that in this red box that one of the lecturers has sent an email inviting Annie to a Microsoft Teams page. So Microsoft Teams is really just a way for the college to deliver video lessons through the lecturer. You've probably experienced Zoom during lockdown where we had a quiz or talking to friends or whatever through Zoom. Well, Teams is just the exact same, except we think it's a wee bit more powerful in terms of allowing us to link to email and My Learning. Remember, My Learning is a new name for Moodle. So we use Teams a lot. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on that email, and I can see that a lecturer is inviting me, Annie Leith, to the NC Computing Level 5 class. So that must be what Annie's on. And it's the Essential Skills lecture because the subject's underneath. It says NC Computing Level 5 Essential Skills. And if I scroll down a wee bit in that email, I see it says Open Microsoft Teams. So I'm going to click on it. Now, what happens is a window comes up and says, oh, do you want to use our app or do you want to use the web instead? So you could use it just through your browser at the very top, or you could use an actual app on your desktop or your tablet or your phone or whatever. So I'm just going to go with the web app. And what's happened here is it's realized, Microsoft Teams has realized, oh, this is Annie Leith who signed into Office 365. So let's just check. Annie, is it this account that you want? Now, I've scored out the blue one because that's me, the person who's talking. I don't want to share that or distract you with that email address at the moment. So we're going to click on Annie. There's some activity on the screen. Again, look, it's linking to Microsoft Office. So everything's connected. Again, prompts me whether I want to use the app or use the Windows app or use the web app. So I'm just going to go for the web app. It actually doesn't make a great deal of difference. I personally use the web app, sorry, the Windows app, but the web app actually looks the exact same. You decide which one works for you. Try them both. Okay, so I've been taken to the Microsoft Teams page that lecturer invited me to, and you can see there it is. I've put a wee red square around it, the NC Computing Level 5 class, and it's the Essential Skills lecturer. So she has her own Teams page that we're going to now use. Ah, there we go. So it's Fiona McFarlane. Great. So Fiona's great. She's sent a wee or put up a wee post that's a welcome to everybody, just saying how we're going to do. And she's saying, oh, you can give me a thumbs up if you've seen this message. So that's really helpful because she's already starting to communicate with her students and trying to make sure that they understand how they're going to work this year. And look down here, she sent an invite to the first class. That's blended learning. So what's about to happen is Fiona is likely to be at home, but she's inviting people to the lesson, which she's going to do through her laptop, and the rest of the students are going to receive this invite and then join the lesson. Okay, so let me just go back. I'm going to click that blue bar inside the red box that I've highlighted. And there's what Fiona's done. She's set up a lesson on the 22nd of September at 9 o'clock. And it's probably just it's a half hour, just kind of general introduction, just make sure people can use it. Now, in the box on the right hand side, I have hidden and obscured the names of other people who have accepted, but you can see in the box at the left hand side, I'm just going to add it to my calendar. So here goes. It says accepted. And if I go back into my email, look down the left hand side, you see I put a wee red square on it. That's the calendar. So I'm going to click on that and look what's happened. There's the invite now appearing in my calendar. So if you get an invite from a lecturer, accept it and it'll appear in your calendar. Why is that important? Because when you click that invite, look what's now there, a join button. So you click that when the class is about to start. So at 9 o'clock on Tuesday 22nd, the people in Fiona's class are now going to click that. Fiona will be able to see them. They'll be able to see Fiona, and then they can decide how they want to work it from there on in. What you can also do is you can let Fiona know on any of your lectures whether you'll attend by clicking that yes, I'll attend. Okay, so what have we covered here? It's really about blended learning and how we think staff will begin to communicate with you for online classes. I hope this works for you. It's one way that we think is simple, but it takes a wee bit of getting used to. But once it's started, it's fairly simple because you know that you go into your email and you'll see invites from staff for the lesson. That's how you join them. Okay, so a quick summary. What did we do? We went through my learning, step one. Step two, we clicked on my email in the right-hand side. Step three, we got an invite to Microsoft Teams and we joined that, we accepted it. And that's where the lecturer was waiting for us with an invite to the class. So, a couple of things just to go over before we finish. Step four is don't worry if it takes you a while to understand how each part of blended learning will work for you. We're all going through the same stage. The staff are trying to make sense of it because it's relatively new for us. And it'll be relatively new for the students who were here last year and people who are joining us for the first time. Well, it's going to be completely new, but don't worry, we're here to support you. The other thing is, if you can figure it out in your class, share that with your classmates. Share what tips you've worked out work actually quite simply and take a few steps. There's lots of actual ways to get to that lesson that Fiona sent. I'm just showing you one way that I think is straightforward, but there's other ways. And also expect that lecturers may do things slightly differently from class to class. This is they are all trying to contact you to help you turn up to the class that is taking place online, but they may send an invite slightly differently, but your email is key, okay? And also, of course, keep asking questions. We're here to help, and we want to make sure that it's a good experience for you this year. It'll be an exciting year. It's certainly different from the year we've had last year. So hopefully this is a good experience for you. Watch the video. If you've got any questions, ask staff once you get their email address, and it's very important that you go back and watch the video about signing into Office 365, because if you don't do that, you won't be able to access what we've just shown you just now. Okay, take care, and I hope to see you at some point during the year at Ayrshire College. Okay, thank you very much.